G'day fellas, welcome to a casted game where we're starting a minute and 20 through. We had a few technical difficulties, but we're doing this one live. We don't know who wins, we don't know who loses, and we don't know who starts where on this map, but we have got spawning in the west of the map on the color green. It's I Want a Baby with Garja, and I tell you what, I'm feeling the exact same way because these maps are looking great, and it's not just Garja that's doing it, but he's doing a lot of it. So this player is also going to be known by the name of Sompu, so we're going to be going for a little bit of a treasure contention here. Kaiser Klein just doing the classic thing that he does, and yes, that is indeed the one and only the Kaiser Klein, who's going to be playing on the Germans this game, spawning in on the east of the map. Great to see him playing the game again.
He's back.
He's loving it. And we spot his explorer. So this move right here that Kaiser Klein is doing is known as the Kaiser Klein. Very infamously, because Kaiser Klein is an aggressive player. And one of the things he loves to do in the early game is just force the opponent's explorer back, constantly back to the base. And so he will do it as long as he's got like even a slight HP advantage. Let's say like a 1 HP advantage. He will force the opponent's explorer all the way back to the base. And just really try and obtain that early lead. And this is exactly what he's doing here. So doing a great job of just forcing the explorer from Sompu back into the base. He's most likely going to be getting it here. If we take a look over at Sompu, he's going to have to idle villagers if he wants to try and prevent this. But even if he does, it's almost 100% going to go down. And there you go. The final shot in the back of the head. Going to take that explorer out. So now we've got the age up beginning for Sompu. Going up with a naturalist. And once again, having a little bit of time issues there, but it looks like it seems to have resolved itself. So with the naturalist, a little bit of a meta choice, I would say, something that we haven't seen a lot of when it comes to this explorer. But I'm a big fan of it. I think it's a good idea, especially for the British. You don't really have a lot of options when it comes to your age ups. Like obviously, you don't have the quartermaster. You've got access to the governor and the philosopher prince, and it's kind of like, well, what do you really want out of those two? Like, sure, you know, an early tower is nice, and sure, a little bit of extra coin's good, but I mean, you get two extra villages, and for the British that are going to be getting market upgrades, it kind of makes sense. But you know what doesn't make sense? When you send your villager out like this looking for hunts and you can't bloody find them. Where the hell are they? Oh my god, look, he can't find any hunts. He's going to be absolutely mad. This is classic Definitive Edition. He spotted a hunt now behind his base, but this villager out the front goes pretty much with its head in its hands, and a little bit just defeatist. Let's take a look over at Kaiser Klein. We'll see what he's up to. Kaiser Klein going to be taking a trading post in the north of the map. Also going to be able to begin looking at that transition, going with the quartermaster here, and hello? Looks to be getting a little bit funky in the transition period. I actually see we've got a bit of a Kaiser Klein in the chat at the moment. Kaiser Klein, please no spoilers. We're casting this live. We're curious exactly what's going to happen. We're not too sure, but we're looking forward to it because we've got Europeans here. We don't actually see a lot of Europeans at the moment. It's mainly those African civs, and it's great to see that we've got you back in the game. Right. Looks like a second trading post may be getting dropped down when the quartermaster comes through. Let's take a look and spot exactly what happens. Age up has now happened. Three settlers, tower all the way up. Looks like the explorer is just going to be heading towards this 40 XP treasure. Sompu, on the other hand, dropping down that barracks, sending in the 700 wood as his first shipment in the second age. We take a look back over at Kaiser Klein, see what he's up to. Kaiser Klein looking pretty ferocious at this point. Now, keep in mind that for the Germans, there's a new buff, or it's almost like a buff for the Germans, because you've now got access to the military home city shipments. So I'm curious to see whether we spot Kaiser Klein actually change this over and then get his Uhlans delivered to the front base and, you know, have the settler wagons at the back. We don't actually see that happening from him. So it could have been a nice little way to just get a couple few seconds, because now the Uhlans are going to have to run out. You know, that might be, say, 10, 15 seconds, something like that. It's those little things. But I'm sure he'll adapt to that change. Now got that second trading post up. Also getting the steel traps, 700 wood coming in behind this. So definitely sticking with that old semi-FF meta. We got 10 idle villagers at the moment. Wake up, Sompu. What's happening? Sompu going quite a bit idle. I think he must have been picking up those wood crates, and that's exactly sort of why he's gone idle. Also picking up some of the cows as well. First villager looks to get hit down. He does have his greatcoats in, so it's going to take quite a few more hits. That villager manages to survive, I think, because of the greatcoats. There were 5 hits from the Uhlans that did come through, so we'll have to double-check the health on that villager and see exactly. It had 54 health. It would have survived with 2 HP anyway, so very, very close. 5 villagers now coming through for Sompu. Five muskets moving to the north of the map as well. Going to begin sieging down this trading post. Now, keep in mind, Kaiser Klein has opened with a tower here. So we'll be looking to see whether he sends through any more of those aggressive shipments or whether he just focuses on sticking with these, you know, the 700 wood, 700 coin, standard semi-FF stuff that you expect to see out of German players and especially out of semi-FF gang leaders, that's for sure. Ulan's now going to be moving over towards the pikes. They almost look to be hunting down the pikes, and that's what they are indeed are doing. So going to be able to pick off 2-3 pikes. So smart that he actually managed to split them up. If these four pikes had all been together, it would have been a different story for these Ulans, but you can just see how much damage has already been done to the pikes by the Explorer, and now the Ulans are going to pick up 4 pikes, barely taking any damage. Just a little bit of damage on this Ulan, and that was from the town center. It wasn't even from the pikes themselves, so really nice play from Kaiser Klein there. Also going to be sending through 8 crossbows now from the home city, so not opting towards that semi-FF play. He's got his trading post on both on wood, rather. We spot how his opponent, Sompu, is doing. And Sompu definitely looking like he wants to go towards that Fortress Age, sending through the 700 coin. Pike's coming out now as well. He's got to be careful. He's got this trading post up to the north. Highly likely that it's going to be sort of going the way of the Dodo, unfortunately, because I suspect that Kaiser's going to be able to push in and really apply a lot of pressure up here to the north. We see a couple crossbows. It looks like just 2 crossbows have come out. Going to be getting a nice little cheeky snare. First crossbow goes down. Explorer going to be going down, picking up free 45 experience, and going to be having that age up in queue in less than 30 seconds, undoubtedly. I'm looking to spot whether we've got any more units moving up here from Kaiser Klein. We do indeed have plenty more units coming up here from Kaiser Klein. 14 crossbows. We've got those 6 Ulans and just a handful of pikes, just in case there's any potential cavalry. But look at the way that he's doing that micro. Just so on point, focusing down those muskets on the back line. Let's see if he brings those hussars back. He does. He gets that nice little dance going. And a great job. We've got more muskets here over on the left-hand side. And just balancing it very, very carefully. Making sure he doesn't engage in melee combat too much with those pikes. Really just keeping them interested. And you can see the way that he's not even stopping to kill this pike with his crossbows. I say that, and then he just immediately kills it. So it looks like he's on the hunt, basically wanting to hit over on these musketeers and hunts for them. At the same time, though, this trading post is now under threat. More crossbows going to be linking up with those initial crossbows from Kaiser Klein, and we do have the age up in queue now for Sompu. Sompu going to be going up with the adventurer. So looking to get that third age in. Probably going to be aiming for something like a 7 Falconet switch. That's what I would be expecting out of, you know, these top-level British players. So hopefully that's what we see here from Sompu. He's quite heavily on gold, but he's going to have to be jumping inside that town center, getting in there real quick. No longer going to be able to hit that front gold mine, so a bit of a difficult spot for him. First village are going to be going down. Second village are going to be going down as well. So a couple losses going out for him. Town center going to be working its way down, just shooting off a few of those low HP low HP crossbows. And now up towards the north, we spot exactly how Kaiser Klein's doing. He's managed to clean up that first trading post. Behind this, he does have the 700 gold that has arrived from the home city. He's pretty heavily on berries here. Now, keep in mind, settler wagons do gather a lot faster than your standard settlers, but at the same time, they are, you know, they're still settlers. You'd want these guys on hunts, but there's just really not any available hunts around here. The furthest one is, or the closest one's all the way out here, and he really just wants to focus on getting up to the next age. So that's exactly what he's going to do. We've got a couple units that are just hovering around this area. 7 musketeers doing their best just to create a little bit of a diversion. That's exactly what they're doing. Now aging up, going to be going up with the Exiled Prince. 99.9% of the time, it is what you do see. So technically, we've got Sompu doing a semi-FF because he aged up just before 10 minutes. Kaiser Klein, however, not doing the semi-FF here, opting for a little bit more of age to play. So you love to see it out of the semi-FF gang leader. Now going to be sending in or sending through those 2 Falconets, the most overpowered shipment in the game. Come I have called it. 7 longbows in from the age up as well. So dropping down that second barracks, and you can see he's training pikes now. So a curious decision. I'm not sure exactly why we've got pikes being trained. I feel like, you know, at this point in the game, you kind of need all your wood for upgrades, and really you want to be building towards that composition where you've got muskets and longbows. But obviously he could be expecting to see something like the 9 Ulan shipment together with veteran Ulan, so I wouldn't be surprised to see that. Veteran crossbows are the first option for first upgrade that Kaiser Klein's going to be looking for, as well as sending in 3 war wagons from the home city. He's got that stable back, so going to be looking to provide all the anti-artillery and anti-cavalry through these war wagons. Really nice unit, so hopefully he's going to get out a nice big batch of that. We see all of these idle villagers, probably going to prevent that from that big batch from coming through. Outpost now going down. Second barracks and the first barracks going to be going down as well. Gets that veterancy upgrade. So he's looking like he's in a pretty decent spot here. But my main concern is just he doesn't really have any food source. He's got this food source back here, but it's not really a lot. Compare that over to his opponent, who's, you know, very comfortably hunting up here to the north. He's got the pikes out here just in case. You know, just in case.
Yes.
And it makes a lot of sense when you consider... Now we've got the crossbows beginning to push forward, taking out a couple musketeers. Looks like two muskets go down. A third musket now going to be going down as well. So Kaiser Klein just doing a nice job to just get a little bit of damage out there. Thin that army down a little bit.
Ready.
The first or the next shipment's come in. We've got five hussars from the home city, from Sompu. Kaiser, on the other hand, looking pretty darn healthy over here. Eight war wagons are out for him. Now, he's got no infrastructure, really, when it comes to his military production. He's got a single stable. That's going to be it for him. So, no ability to be training skirmishers at this point. He's going to be having to invest completely in war wagons. Oh, no. We've got a terrible, terrible trade right here because Sompu's left his falconets just sitting open. And Kaiser Klein's picked up the first one. The second one's down to 116 HP. So, this is not a good spot at all for him. Doing a great bit of dodging here. So, just basically giving up the most powerful shipment in the game. Oh, you hate to see it. That is really, really tough. Oh, my lord. So, now going to be beginning to push in. Kaiser Klein just slowly microing away. You know, he's only got access to this stable at this point in time. So, he says, you know what? I'm not going to make skirmishers. I'm just going to make veteran war wagons. That's all I need. And now we got a bit of a game pause. And you guys know what happens in the pause, the game time. For anybody who's watching this back on YouTube, it's most likely going to be cut through to the next when we unpause. But for those who are with me on Twitch, got a little story to tell you right now. Back when I was a little youngin, g'day fellas, says little cook, g'day. I'll tell you guys a story. My parents, they're separated. And I used to love spending time with my dad because we'd play strategy games together. The first strategy game I ever played was an RTS by the name of Total Annihilation. Yes!
I got something to report to
Icon Top, thank you very much for coming in with the Prime Gaming. And I got to see my dad once every 2 weeks. He'd pick me up on a Friday afternoon and he'd take me home on a Sunday afternoon. And I remember I was playing in the backyard and my mum screamed out as I was playing in the backyard. She said, "Keaton, your father's here." And so I ran as fast as I could through the backyard. I was playing in the sandpit at the time. I ran up the sandpit and... Oh, wait, we're back into the game. Never mind. The story's going to have to come back in later. Back into the game. Anyway, I tripped over. I was running so fast because I was so excited to go see my dad because we were going to play RTS together. And I tripped over. I hurt my knee and I cried and I got a Band-Aid and it was all better. Mum kissed it better. But look, you'll be pleased to know that I made a full recovery and I'm still a big lamer today. That's it. That's essentially it. So we'll take a look at how Kaiser Klein is doing.
Yeah.
He's obviously the fan favorite. He's who everyone wants to see. We spot that he's moving up towards the north. He would know that this hunt is dead here, but he wouldn't... obviously he's going to know that this hunt is getting protected. It's the closest one to the base. He's going to know that there's pikes on top of it or an entire army, you know, that sort of thing. He's just that smart. So very, very cognizant of this and doing a great job of picking that up. Now coming around the back and just seeing if he can spot any villagers out. And that's exactly what he does. So Kaiser Klein doing a great job. Now going to be sending through those 9 Ulans from the home city. He's got to be careful here. Taking out 2 villagers here. He's got a couple pikes in amongst the mix. Now some muskets doing their best to run through. Going to be able to collect these. And looks like they're going to get that volley off. They do. Taking out those Ulans. And we've got to push at the same time on the main base of Sompu. Going to be losing that barracks. Taking down a mana as well. And these Ulans just doing a great job of... You know, if these Ulans are dead, that's fine. Just let them go. But try and distract your opponent as much as you can. We see the army has been all the way up here to the north. And at the same time, going to be losing infrastructure. Villages going down. More villages in the base of Sompu. We've got 2 more falconets coming out. So a total of 3 falconets now. And looking to unload, but they don't get their loads off just too early. And Kaiser Klein falling back now with these crossbows. He's got 30 veteran crossbows. So a significant mass for him. Continuing to mass up those war wagons, though. We do spot that he's stacking up quite a few resources here, so not sure if he's thinking about potentially going to age 4, but speaking of age 4, I tell you what, you're going to need to be in age 4 and ship that estates card after you've lost all these villages over here, Sompu. That is a lot of villages. There's at least six that have gone down here. Another five that are potentially going to be going down here. And Kaiser Klein is in a great lead at this point. Even if he loses all of these Ulans, which he's not going to these pikes, just because they are veteran upgraded. Kaiser Klein wins this game if he doesn't, if he holds this. If he holds this, he wins. That is it. That's my call. 29 villages now. He needs to push in. He needs to make sure that this is a victory push right here. From the home city. Oh my lord, we got three more Falconets. He's pretty close to the 7 Falc right now. He's at 6 Falconets. That's pretty impressive, I'll say that much, but he's got to be careful. The war wagons are moving in, looking to get some snipes off. Minutemen getting called. Kaiser Klein's looking like he wants to go right now. We see the Cav Combat is actually in, or is going to be coming in, but it's a curious call for Minutemen. I'm not sure exactly why he's called them this early. I feel like he probably could have delayed them a little bit, but Kaiser Klein doing his best, just kiting back with the Musketeers. Ulans on the backside, looking to come around, potentially pick that up, but they do get spotted out. The Musketeers are holding this one down. He's got to be careful. This war wagon mass is building. Range cavalry caracol also coming in. Plenty of resources tucked away in the bank for Kaiser Klein. So he's moving forward now with the first Falconet going to be going down. 5 Falconets remain, looking to move forward. He's on plenty of villages. Keep in mind, if he does hold this fight, he does win this game. Second Falconet looking to go down. Does it go down? Second Falconet does indeed go down. Falconets refocusing now, looking to focus down those crossbows, but the Ulans are moving around. The Ulans are moving in on top of the Falconets. The same time we've got the war wagons that are going to be taking them out. 3 Falconets remain. 2 Falconets remain. Both relatively low HP. Still managing to get some pretty decent shots off on this. Sompu Konku looks like he's actually doing pretty well, managing to break at least even at this point. All the war wagons are down. He's going to rely on his town center, but there's no villagers in it to focus down the last Falconet. And Kaiser Klein in a difficult spot right here. He needs to survive this push. If he holds this push, he wins this game. He is so far ahead on economy. Right now, if we do a stock take, he's on 45 villages versus his opponent, who's on 31. That's a 14 villager lead. As long as he holds on here, he's going to be okay. But the difficult spot for him is he's got no infrastructure. He's got a single stable, and it's going to get focused down. Sompu doing his best. We see a single villager in here, slowly focusing down this Falconet. One damage at a time, and look at this. This batch is not going to get out. Kaiser Klein in a very difficult spot. Counter infantry rifling coming in, but it's not going to help out his crossbowmen, because, my friends, these guys do not hold crossbows. They are not skirmishers. Kaiser Klein in a difficult spot right now. House is beginning to get siege down. He's sitting on 100 population, so it's not a particularly hard spot, but I think we can definitely see some of the problems that Kaiser Klein is facing right now. Just so many resources sitting banked up. He's got 5 skirmishers ready to come out, 5 war wagons as well, about to come out as well. That house, or that town, gosh, my, oh my lord, that Falconet going down. I think it might have been an explorer buyback. I'm not sure exactly what happened there. It's not an explorer buyback. I don't know what killed that. I suspect it was probably just the trickle of the town center fire. But now we've got Sompu, who's in a decent position. Plenty of muskets massed up. More Falconets coming in. Is this going to be the killing blow? Is this going to be what it needs? What Sompu needs to finish off this game? 8 skirmishers coming through, as well as 3 Ulans. He's got to make his mind up. Is he going to try and fight on this right now? What does he do? Because the skirms are going to come in right here at the back. No, they're not. They're going to come at the north, where the second town center has been rebuilt. Kaiser Klein is thinking ahead. He knows that he needs to hold on here, but at the same time, he doesn't have enough energy. He doesn't have enough oomph. He lost that early infrastructure. He put it very aggressively down. The opponent was able to push him in, and now he begins to look and posture towards his potential push that he sees. Kaiser Klein now pulling ahead in score, about 1.2k up, and a pretty decent game, I'll say, so far.
Yeah.
Veteran war wagons, got to be careful here. And same with all those settlers. Look out, Kaiser Klein. Wake up, Kaiser Klein. Kaiser Klein does wake up. First villager going to be going down and focusing down this stable. So Kaiser Klein going to be losing another 400 wood of infrastructure here. We've got a batch of skirmishers that gets cancelled at the last second, and doing his best just to try and focus down these skirmishers on the front line. Unfortunately for him, though, it looks like Kaiser Klein still continues to be in a difficult spot. It looks like for the first time in this game, he may actually get popped from the hard work of his opponent. His opponent's now up to 37 villages, Sompu Konku is. So a decent effort from him to try and get back into this game. Keep in mind, he's still only got that one town center. Kaiser Klein has rebuilt his town center up in the north, so he's going to be able to keep up with him. But if we do a quick little stock take, 37 villages up against his opponent, who's on 40 villages, but that's really 48 villages, so still quite a big lead for him. About 11. Now we've got some culverin out. This should be the end of the game right here if Kaiser Klein is able to hit these shots and take out these double Falconets. Let's see how well he does it. Kaiser Klein looking in. They don't blank fire, so he's feeling pretty good about this one. He's got to be careful, though, because it looks like these Kolvs... Do they have a lock on? They have a lock on! They take out the second Falconet, and they've done everything they needed to do. They've traded out a perfectly here. So very well played by Kaiser Klein, making sure that everything is on point, really doing well. More units down here in the base for Sompu, and Kaiser Klein just getting attacked all over the map. A couple of villagers potentially getting knocked out. We'll take a look at the villager count down to 32 villagers. Oh, poor Sompu Konku, 32 villagers now to his opponent, Kaiser Klein, who sits very comfortably up on 48 villagers right now. So really quite far ahead, about 16 villager population. That score does not lie, up 3,200 at this point. And Kaiser Klein has managed to hold on. It was a long push. It was a hard push. But I tell you what, Kaiser Klein held it with absolute style and incredible patience. You know, a lot of lesser players would have tried to go in, would have fought, and you know, would have died at this last town center fight. But Kaiser Klein really held it together. And you just see the experience from the guy. You know, it is just, you know, classic Kaiser Klein right there. Impressive stuff that he was able to hold out, not give it up. Now we've got, you know, this continuous push that we see out of the British players where they mix in their muskets together with their falconets. But, you know, the difficult thing is up against this German composition, you've got war wagons which double as artillery or anti-artillery and at the same time anti-cavalry. So, you know, you're going to have this skirmisher dragoon. And here we go. Now we've got the counter-infantry rifling on these skirmishers. So keep in mind, 26 skirms out. Going to be doing a great job. And as long as he's able to neutralize those falconets, he's going to be fine. And now we see another culverin in queue. And this is really where the good game gets called, in my opinion, because this culverin is just going to continue to enable Kaiser Klein to just remain ahead. He focuses down the falconet at distance. The counter-infantry rifling skirms are just going to shred through those musketeers. It's just not going to be even close. Down towards the south, or rather, down towards the east of the map. Explorer going to be going down, taking down this trading post as well. Kaiser Klein now looks to be getting pushed upon. And we've got Sompu, who's just once again committing to the town center. Really just loves taking out these town centers. A couple of villagers going to be going down for Kaiser Klein. It's not like he realizes, but undoubtedly he realizes that this fight is going to be pretty much the end of the game right here. This is going to be the final fight. If he wins this, if he holds this, he's going to be able to hold or take the game. Minutemen getting called. Veteran war wagons up the north doing a great job. 10 of these guys are out. And just look at the counter infantry rifling skirms. You don't even need the Kolvs at this point. You can just dive this. There wouldn't be a problem. But Kaiser Klein isn't going to take any risks here. Falconets going down. First Falconet down. Lock on the second one. And good game has been called. Victory to Kaiser Klein. Congratulations go over to him. An incredible game. A lot of action there. Very well played. I am so impressed. Out of all the games we decided to cast, that was the one that we got. Very well played. If you'd like to see more from Kaiser Klein, I'm going to leave a link in the description on this YouTube video to Kaiser Klein's Twitch channel. Make sure you leave a follow and hit that notification icon so that every time he goes live, you get a little email notification. Thank you so much for watching, and I will catch you guys in the next one.